Hey everybody, this is Garrett with Diary of a Family, and I'm here in my GS Lighting studio to bring you another dad tech review. And today's product that we're going to review is the DJI Osmo Mobile 2. It is a very affordable handheld mobile gimbal for your smartphone. So let's go ahead and go over a few of the things about this as I open it up. So one of the things you'll notice is that very nice packaging when you order it, and it comes with a fantastic case. So go ahead and open it up. And this gimbal, it's basically for beginners. If you're into professional videography, you're not going to be using this. What this is for families, for beginners, people that want to get into the market but haven't quite yet. At $129, this is almost a no-brainer for anybody wanting to increase their video quality. This is perfect for Instagram stories, and I'll show you that in a moment. It's also great for just family videos. If you have a YouTube channel that you're trying to build up, you can get amazing shots just from the gimbal here. So let's go ahead and open it up. I'll leave a link in the description below so that you can actually check out this product for yourself and see if this is something that you might want to buy. All right, so what comes in the case is, of course, the gimbal, and then a micro USB cable so that you can charge it up. So the battery life is 15 hours, which is pretty good for a gimbal. I say 15 hours, the caveat is if you use the battery pack to charge a device, battery pack is right, you can plug your phone or something into the USB port on the back. It does drain it significantly. I got about an hour to an hour and a half of use while the gimbal was charging the phone. So for long shoots or things like that, I wouldn't recommend it. But for a short shoot that you have like 15% battery on your phone, but you really kind of need to get like three or four shots and you don't want to just drain your battery, you can plug it in to the gimbal and just go. All right, it is a three-axis gimbal. So you have one, two, and three axis. You can adjust it to fit your smartphone, because everything is adjustable. So in a small phone or a large phone, all should be able to fit very easily in this gimbal. Let's go over some of these buttons real quick. All right, so the first one is the mode button. If you hold it down for 3 seconds, it turns on the gimbal. This button, the red button, starts and stops recording or taking pictures, depending on the mode that you have selected in the app. And then there's two more items. One is the remote control. It's very tactile, very easy to use. It controls the pan and the tilt. So the pan and the tilt of your phone, and also allows you to invert it if that is something you prefer. And then on the side here is your zoom. You have zoom in and out. And then on the other side is your charging port for the included USB. And one other thing to note here on the bottom, it has a standard attachment for a tripod. This is fantastic if you're doing any of the time-lapse, hyperlapse shots where you need to be able to move it, but not wanting to hold it still for 15, 20 minutes. So let's go ahead and put it together. So one thing you want to do is you make sure you get the DJI Go app. It is available on Android and on iOS. And that allows you to connect directly to the gimbal. You don't have to use the app. You can use just the regular camera app, and I've used it before, and it's great. But there are a few modes, especially in the time-lapse and hyperlapse modes, where you actually have to use the app. So let's go ahead and get it put on the gimbal. And you want to kind of get it nice and snug down below and make sure it's clamping on. I tried to use this without a case, and this phone is basically too small to be able to easily fit in here. But you can make it work. Move it back and forth, find a place that works. And once you get that, you want to make sure that it rests flat so that you're not putting extra work on the servos and on the motors. So you want to go ahead and move it in just a bit until you get it where you need it to be. And that was just a little too much. There we go. And then you can kind of play with the back and forth until you get it exactly. See how it's leaning straight? And that's where you want it to be. So when you turn on the power, you hold it down and then it turns on. Once it is on, you can go ahead and connect your device and refresh it, find, all right, there we go. Connect, and there you have it. So as you can tell, it is connected. So it allows you to do, see, I am moving it here, and you can kind of tell the camera is moving a little bit, but you don't have any shake. So I'll show you a few of the modes, especially with the mode button. I'm not gonna go into all of this because I'm gonna explain more when I kind of do a demonstration. So the biggest modes here, you hit it once, and it allows you to, as you can see, I'm rotating the handle, but it's not changing the pan. So it's staying directly on. This allows you to do side to side pans, and then you can turn it back off and it will follow based off of how you twist the handle. Now you tap it three times, one, two, three, and it turns it around to your face camera. This is really nice when you want to be able to quickly get to the face camera, talk about something, and then you can one, two, three, push it right back out. So that is the basics of the camera. And as you can see, you can pan up and down, you can pan left and right. Very, very simple. Now I'm gonna show you some tips using the Osmo Mobile 2 from a recent trip we took. I'm gonna show you some shots with the gimbal, some shots with a selfie stick. Let's go ahead and take a look at these video clips now. So one of the main reasons I wanted to put all these clips together is show you kind of what the difference between a gimbal shot and a handheld shot looks like, or non-stabilized shot. So what you see here is a handheld shot, and you can kind of see the shakiness. I did slow it down a bit to make it a little smoother. That was in my editor, and something you do in post. So this was a Steadicam sequence I created. I took it from one single shot. One thing I did notice was that the camera kept trying to refocus. And I'm not sure, I think it's probably a software issue, as if you're using your regular phone camera, you're probably not gonna have this issue. I didn't have this issue when I was just using the camera app on my phone and not the app. But there's other features on the app that you can't get off your camera. So I wanted to show you some of those. But before I showed you some of those extra shots, I wanted to show you this really cool shot. I took this handheld shot with a selfie stick, non-stabilized, slowed it down, kind of try to look a little cinematic. Just because it was a beautiful day out that day and the kids were really enjoying the ferry. And I wanted to show you what the difference is. I kind of tried to do the same shot and you see just how much smoother the shot is. I mean, it was very simple. Just walked behind my daughter, did the camera shot, did a nice little pan up, and I'm just absolutely amazed by how much better of a shot it is just using my phone. And I'm not using the biggest iPhone or anything like that. I'm using iPhone SE. So it's really quite impressive with what they can do just by being able to make your shot more stable. So there's a couple little walking shots that I did as well. And as you can see, just a lot of fun. And play with it, get used to how it works. It's really just a cool device. So now I want to get into some of the hyperlapse and other modes. Hyperlapse allows you to do basically like a time-lapse sequence, except you're moving. So I really enjoy it. It's really a cool novelty type shot, gets you people's attention. You can do walk through crowded streets and other stuff that you wouldn't normally be able to do with your phone. And the last one I wanted to talk about is motion lapse. Motion lapse allows you to take multiple points and set the duration and the length and all that of your shot. This really makes some extremely smooth time-lapse shots that are just fantastic. I absolutely love them. Hope you guys enjoyed that short video. It's a fantastic device. I really don't find too much faults, especially at its price range. A lot of people have issues saying, oh, it doesn't have this feature, it doesn't have that feature. But I'm coming at it from a perspective of a parent, of a dad, of someone who doesn't have unlimited funds, that can't spend $300 on a gimbal. What this is fantastic for are for people that are on a budget that don't have the money and they can actually have a gimbal. It's really a easy way to upgrade the quality of your videos, and I believe it's something that can benefit most people, even people that are more professional on their photography and video stuff. This is a great option. So the one mode I want to show you is the vertical mode. This allows you to turn your phone into the vertical position. So what you'll basically, all you'll do, you'll do the same kind of calibrations to make it the same, sit the same way. So what you do is you loosen this up, and once you're loosened, you turn it sideways and then you tighten it back down. And then when the gimbal turns on, it's in the vertical position. I personally don't shoot much in vertical because I like to take my videos and put them in with more traditional videos, like with my Canon EOS M50. So I don't have to change orientations and all this other stuff. It just gets kind of messy. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, make sure to leave a comment below on, tell us how you like this video. Tell us also if you like a tech review kind of from a perspective of a dad. I know it's kind of not your usual perspective, but see, you know, I kind of want to know if you find this insightful. Also, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, hit that subscribe button. Hit the notification bell if you want to get notified of any new videos we have coming out. And we'll see you guys in another chapter of our diary. Bye.